So we're going to look today at two different attacks to our partner's far leg. Because most of the time in jiu-jitsu, as jiu-jitsu practitioners primarily, we're not always that good at taking the person all the way down. But we can often take people out of balance and stumble them. And so it's important for us to be able to have a follow-up so that once our initial attack fails, as happens on the ground, we have something that we can do. And because we have the advantage of being able to grip the leg, we can transition from gripping only at the upper body to gripping upper body and lower body, which is what we're gonna do today. Our first attack is gonna be a very basic attack, Sasae. And Sasae is one of the first things that you learn in judo as a kind of rotational throw. And it's a very good technique to know if you're a jiu-jitsu practitioner, because it does do a lot with a little bit of effort. Right, it's not a big throw. You know, a lot of times in jiu-jitsu, we tend to avoid big turn throws or we're turning our back. But Sasae is a pretty low risk, high reward throw. Yeah. So we're going to start with that. We're going to begin with grips. We'll start from right versus right. Nothing fancy here. If you can get your hand above your partner's hand, that's a good idea. So if his hand is a little bit lower than mine, that's great. If you can take your partner's hand off, that's even better. But you can't always do that. So we're starting right versus right. We're going to square our partner up. So we'll step back with our rear leg, and we're gonna give a pull with our front hand here to get our partner's feet a little bit more square. Okay, his leg back there is a little hard for me to hit when I go to reach to off balance. So we're gonna square our partner up. And we're gonna step our outside leg up to the line of our partner's leg. We're gonna pull with our right hand, push with our left, bring our hips forward. The goal is that the sole of your foot is gonna block down here by your partner's ankle. You turn your partner's shoulders, you wheel them around the corner, and you get them out of balance. So that's the basics of our Sasae. We keep our partner's hand low, we step pull, square them up, we step up, and we go to block. So you'll see that off of a failed Sasae, your partner will have to adjust by stepping that rear leg back so that he doesn't fall down. If he doesn't, then he's just gonna keep wheeling until he hits the mat. So he'll usually step this leg back. That's what we're looking for. So as we hit our throw here, and we see our partner wheeling, we're gonna drop. You're gonna keep your hand tight, elbow bent, your head goes here towards your own hand. This hand, which was holding the sleeve, this is gonna reach and it's gonna control around your partner's knee. You're gonna go elbow deep. Then your lead knee is gonna drop, you're gonna pull with your hands, lift with your other one, and settle your partner down into a position where you're either in the flank or ready to attack the leg, okay? So let's look at that one more time. Collar sleeve. His hand lower, step pull square. We step up Sasae here. It fails, we drop immediately while our partner is out of balance. Hand and head connect, we hug our partner's leg, elbow deep, knee goes to the floor, and then we drive with our head here, settling our partner down, and we're in a position where we're prepared to pass. So that's our first attack. Our second attack is similar, except that instead of a wheeling attack like Sasae, where we block and turn our partner, we're gonna use a Kosoto hook on our partner's far leg. So this involves us reaching the same foot, so it's our right versus our partner's left, where we step up and we make a hook behind our partner's ankle. Now you need to be a little bit cautious of doing this when your partner's leg is kind of far away, because as I reach my leg, he can let his left hand off the gi pick up my leg, and then we have all sorts of problems for single legs and counters. So as a good rule of thumb, we like to do the same thing that we did the first time around. We like to square our partner up to bring their foot a little closer to us. So we step pull, and there it is. Now we bend our knees, we take our near leg, we reach and we just make a hook with our foot, pulling with our toes, anywhere between our partner's knee and their ankle. We're gonna drive with our hands and get our partner stepping, and there is the same back step we were looking for. We're gonna take this foot, we're gonna drop that knee to the floor, and we're gonna catch and settle our partner down once again. So you have this ability to knee pick or even ankle pick your partner off of these throws. So we begin. One, square them up. Two, Kosoto. We walk, there's the step. We drop our knee, catch here. Look how the hand is still pulling, guiding his head down. We circle, settle our partner down. Now we're in a position where we can work to pass or to come back and ankle lock our partner. So it helps to have a great uke and a great partner to work with when you're first learning these throws, someone who knows how to fall properly. If you're too stiff as the uke, sometimes it can be difficult for the tori to get the connection that they need. So starting slow and building from here so your partner can learn how to fall safely, you can be comfortable in your transition. This hopefully will help you a lot. Okay, thank you for watching. Sensei, thank you so much.
Thank you.